Hello, Yahweh Bashamir Shai Bashamir Kakwadash. Double honors unto the apostles and elders of Great Millstone. Peace and blessings to you, hopeful elect, scattered across all nations. And Shalak Rayam to you, demons. And of course, Shalom to the elect. Just a quick lesson going into how Esau knows who we so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Indians really are. And you'll find the proof of that in the most obscure places. My son, who is an IT specialist and an avid gamer, recently directed my attention to the multiplayer faceted game Elden Ring, and I came across a character which was the reason for my latest aha moment. Phone had a chime on that. Shalom to Elder Apostle Gabor. As far as Esau's knowledge of we Israelites, that he'll never be forthright in telling you, but he'll sprinkle everyday happenstances with morsels of truth for those who really have eyes to see. Now, Elder Apostle Tahar always gives the example of Hollywood, the big screen, and how the elite no longer hide it in a book, because don't you know, the monkeys, they read now. They more than often now speak to each other through coded messages in film and major motion pictures, as well as the predictive programming Sleazy E is famous for, using TV, drama, sitcoms, and even advertising to normalize his agendas and the narratives he is about to unleash on the public. It would appear nowhere is sacred when it comes to this nuance, and I say that facetiously because really these subtle hints of the truth is, and it's always been, the work of the Heavenly Father. 2 Corinthians 13:8 reads, for we can do nothing against the truth, but for the truth, simple and plain, no matter what, the truth stands alone. Nothing can get in its way. One way or another, no matter how much time has elapsed, the truth has to come out and it has to be made manifest. John 8:32 says this, and ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. The truth starts with knowing the scriptures, which is a testament to who we really are in the present time. No one goes into the scriptures and can break them down like we, the hopeful elect of Israel. And may I say, starting from the elders on down and on the members of Great Millstone, the scriptures tell you that the oracles, Yahweh's statutes, meaning his law and his order, his judgments are given to his people, and he has not dealt so with any other nation. Roughly paraphrasing Psalm 147, 1 Corinthians 13:9. Another verse that came to mind. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part, but when that which is perfect is come, then that which is in part shall be done away. We have full understanding, having been given 100% truth by the Heavenly Father, but it is Yahweh who has full knowledge of all things in existence and the things to come, namely how everything is going to play out. When the elect are delivered, when what is perfect comes, we too will have knowledge of all things according to the Spirit of the Heavenly Father. But for now, here's a perfect segue into what I came across in Elden Ring, was the character named the Prophet. As soon as I had saw the character model, I was like, tell me this devil Esau don't know who he had in captivity. For those listening while they work or drive, as I've come to understand, some of my viewers do, the game character here named the Prophet has a yoke around his neck, shackles on his feet, and is blindfolded, which in itself, it speaks volumes when you consider that the very same representation you see when you Google a yoke, this one, of course, made of iron, or specifically speaking to Jeremiah 30:8. You know what? Matter of fact, let's get that. Jeremiah 30:8. Salakia. And it reads, for it shall come to pass in that day, saith Yahweh the Lord of hosts, that I will break his yoke from off thy neck, and will burst thy bonds, and strangers shall no more serve themselves of him. Which directly speaks to our subjection and servitude to the other nations at the hands of Esau, Edom, and Amalek, and the so-called white man, and the so-called modern-day Jews, the Jewish. Masquerading as us, of course, and the role they played using the slave trade. the yoke still remains up until today. The third verse in Jeremiah 30 speaks about all tribes being united, not one single tribe, and we going back into the land to possess it. I mean, the book itself speaks to us ruling the land again in righteousness and peace. If the true people of the book are in the land we know today is present day Israel, then why is wickedness allowed to run rampant? I mean, kosher cigarettes and kosher pork and gay parades and whatnot. I mean, you tell me. These things, you know, these are things you must ponder in questioning the validity of any nation claiming to be the descendants of the Hebrew biblical Israelites, our ancestors. When you do, you soon see their claims just don't add up. I mean, the word truth in the Hebrew is amath, which gives us the word math. Ergo, if it doesn't add up, then it just doesn't make sense. Pun intended. Moving on, you know, going back to this symbology of what is being presented by this character, the vast majority of Israelites today are blind to their true nationality. And I'm speaking to that of this character presented with a blindfold. You know, the vast majority of we Israelites today, that we're just not knowing who we are. It's, you know, our true identity. Speaking to, I guess, you know, Proverbs 21 and 16 comes to mind. You know, Proverbs 21 and 16 calls it being in the congregation of the dead. And on a parabolic level, what should be mentioned before anything else is that we who bear witness to the power and spirit of Yahweh Bashem Yerushai are prisoners of hope, being led by what the world calls blind faith. Let's go to 2 Corinthians 5 and 7, and it says what? For we walk by faith, not by sight. Meaning we don't judge things by seeing or put our trust in something because it is quote unquote tangible. Meaning because we can see it and touch it. We, by having the gift of faith given to us by the Heavenly Father, that we are of Yahweh's chosen people, and through the Spirit revealing what it will, his secrets are made plain to us. James 1 and 17 comes to mind there. And again, we understand these things because of what was made simple and plain to us pursuant to the prophecies written of in the Holy Bible. Now, in the game, there's something called character build. And if you choose to play as the prophet, your source of power, as well as your ability to succeed, is dependent upon your mind, which we know in the scriptures, your heart and your mind are relative to each other, and also your faith. Imagine that. Now, of course, this is Esau we're talking about here, so you know the game is centered around his likeness, even though you can't create your character as any nationality. Still, it is all centered around his observances and his traditions. I believe Ammon was heavily involved in the making of this title as well. But in any event, because it was conceptualized by heathens, it's based on mysticism and deals with idolatry and witchcraft and an occultic negative, we'll call it a negative level. But again, 2 Corinthians 13 and 8, pursuant to the times we're in, ain't no hiding the truth. The truth has to come out. Ergo, the spells and the curses that you are said to be able to cast as a so-called prophet in this game, they call them incantations and sorcery under the classification, of course, magic. But they can be looked at as the spiritual power we will receive, referring to those who remain faithful when Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai returns to impose his will on the earth and earth's inhabitants, the other nations. Isaiah 40 and 31 is a good one. Let's get that. And it reads, "But they that wait upon Yahweh shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary." Salakia. "And they shall walk and not faint." Meaning the elect will be able to fly, walk, run without fatigue. Never mind breaking a sweat. Where do you think DC and the Marvel Universe and all these other Hollywood directors and movie makers get their ideas from? I mean, they get their inspiration for flying men, laser shooting, and lightning wielding from the scriptures. Another good one is Micah 4 and 13. And it reads, "Arise and thresh, O daughter of Zion, for I will make thine horn iron, and I will make thy hoofs brass, and thou shalt beat in pieces many people. And I will consecrate their gain unto Yahweh and their substance unto the Lord of the whole earth." Arise, meaning, there's that phone again. Arise, meaning the Lord is going to raise up and put his spirit on us. And thresh meaning to break, to trample, to tear, to tread down. like a grape, I squash him like a grape, yes. O daughter of Zion, speaking to we, the elect of Israel, Lord willing, Yahweh Ratzazai, I pray I'm of that number. For I will make thine horn iron. Now, you and I know the strength of iron. Empires have fallen and risen because of it. It is the one agent of war that remains undefeated. When you look into the Hebrew for the word horn, it translates, speaking to in the terms of strength, figuratively, and a flask, which is a container for oil. Oil, we know, is the knowledge, wisdom, and understanding given to us by the Holy Spirit and from pursuant to the Heavenly Father. It also has here horn. It's a musical instrument. Well, the scriptures are a song, and who can sing it better than the elect? And lastly, horn-like projections on the altar, as the brothers before me have brought out, meaning rays of light to radiate or to emit beams. Ergo, Superman or Cyclops or my favorite, Brightburn, who shoots lasers that are razors, shoots rays from his eyes and can fly. Arise also means to lift up. None of these characters that Esau brought to life after his study of the scriptures can hold a candle to the men of the Lord when Yahweh gives us that spiritual power. You know what? Let's straight to the point. Let's close with this. And I pray y'all were edified. To bring the point home, we'll go to Baruch 2 and 30, and it says this: "For I knew that they would not hear me, because it is a stiff-necked people, but in the land of their captivities they shall remember themselves." Speaking to we Israelites, those of us of the one-third, the hopeful elect, who hear and understand this truth and sigh and cry and are patiently, impatiently waiting for the coming of the Heavenly Father through his son, Yahweh Bashem Yahshua, "and shall know that I am Yahweh their power, for I will give them a heart and ears to hear. And they shall praise me in the land of their captivity and think upon my name." It is here in the Western Hemisphere where we are serving out our captivity under the rulership of Esau. We regain the knowledge of our power, meaning our God, or what the those outside of the temple would call God. God is not a name, it is a title. The true name of our power is Yahweh, and his son, whose true name is not Jesus, is Yahweh Shai. It is here under the rulership of Esau we regained the knowledge of our heritage and who we are as a people. Baruch 2 and 33, "And return from their stiff neck and from their wicked deeds, for they shall remember the way of their fathers which sinned before the Heavenly Father. And I will bring them again into the land which I promised with an oath unto their fathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And they shall be lords of it, and I will increase them, and they shall not be diminished." Speaking to present day Israel, which will be returned to our possession after it is cleansed, of course, of all the wickedness and nonsense that's going on there today. Baruch 2 and 35, "And I will make an everlasting covenant with them to be their power, and they shall be my people, and I will no more drive my people of Israel out of the land that I have given them." And again, I didn't intend for this to be long-winded. So with that, I'll close and I say, call halal, Yahweh, Bashem, Yahshai, Bashem, Rakakwadash, through the power and spirit. I hope you were edified. Double honors unto the elders and apostles of great millstone who do rule well and do teach us 100% truth. Shalom to the elect. Remember, no tests, no yab, and damn sure, don't take that C to the hip, that C to the H to the I to the P. Shalom, Yashwala. Shalom to the elect.